That's it? That's it? Yes! This just happened! Okay, let's talk about this. I missed the second and half of the third period. When I came back, it was 10 minutes left in the third, and when I left, Brock Boeser scored his first goal of the game. So I didn't watch everything in between that, so this is based off of opinions that I've heard of other people and everything. This game was apparently very entertaining. And just based off of what I was able to watch, my god, it was entertaining. Aside from the first five shots of the game by the Rangers, wherein Markstrom let in three, and which led to him getting pulled, but overall, this game, a half win. You know what, let's say it's a win for Team Tank. First off, we didn't get 2 points, so that's really good. We got 1 point, which is kind of bad, but we got one instead of two, so that's good. And Boeser got two. Okay. He's up to 29 of the season. Realistically, he should be at 31. Let's face it, it's 31 that he needs to be at because there were two goals that weren't given to him that should have been given to him. But I digress. Brock Boeser in this one. Two pure just Brock Boeser-like goals. And the Canucks, they lose this one 5-4 in overtime. Gilmore gets the game winner. And this one was just a Team Tank win. The whole time, I was like, yo, man, like, why are we scoring? We don't need the score, we can give Boeser goals, that's okay. But this game really did just prove to us that the Canucks do have offensive talent still laying dormant within them. It's really, like, it's obvious, considering the 55 shots on goal, but this team can score for some reason, and we've seen that in a few games recently. The ones that come to mind immediately are the 6-goal performances against, like, Boston and Dallas and all that. But this was another one of those games, guys. 4 goals for the Vancouver Canucks in this one. Let's start things off just talking about all the goals. Except for the first three, because I don't want to talk about any of those. Okay, no, let's talk about the first one a little bit. Yeah, defense. Defense. They probably should have had that one. Probably. John Garrett was kind of right. I think it was icing on that first goal, but he didn't call it. And then all of a sudden, Kevin Hayes behind the net just pulls it out and it's in. It's disgusting. I didn't like that. Then Jimmy Vesey gets one. Then Kevin Hayes gets one. And by this point, I'm like, okay, this is going to be a Team Tank win. Yeah, just give us a Boeser goal and we're good. And then all of a sudden, Brock Boeser, out of nowhere, the fantastic line of Bo Horvat, Brock Boeser, and Philip Holm. Oh wait, sorry, not Philip Holm. Brendan Leipsic, the brand new BBB line, Holm. I'm sorry, man, but your replacement is so good. Brendan Leipsic, Brock Boeser, and Bo Horvat, the BBB number 2 line. Brendan, Brock, Bo. This one is a beauty of a line, and they're so strong on the puck. It's amazing. The pressure on Brock Boeser's first goal of the game was immense. It was indomitable, inexorable, and the Rangers couldn't do anything because, well, McLeod didn't have a stick, and he left to get one. So it was basically a 5-on-4 for, like, 3 seconds, but 3 seconds is all Bo Horvat needed to take the puck at the far left point side of the ice, cross it through the crease, through the slot, over to Boeser, and Lundqvist down the flying windmill. He tries to stop it. Brock Boeser, he's there at the right side of the net, and he's like, yeah, no, you're not stopping this one, boy. He finally has a goal. And I say finally because he should have had a goal a few games ago. He should have had 2 goals in the past few games, considering the fact that the goals... Oh my goodness. If you guys know what I'm talking about, you know this is pissing me off, but there were a few goals earlier in the season, maybe like a week or two ago, in the span of the last week, that should have been Brock Boeser's because they touched him, but like, they weren't given to him, but like, okay, let's stop talking about that. Bo Horvat, a little bit later, on the power play, this one was really good too. This one, just 5 minutes after Brock Boeser's first goal of the game, and this one was really, really good. First off, things get started out with a penalty kill by the Rangers. Kevin Hayes tries to get a hat trick, and he gets poke-checked, so Anders Nielsen, thank you, Base Nielsen, and the Sedins come right back the other way. Sedins over Daniel, takes the puck in the slot off of Henrik's pass from the hash marks. Shot, Lundqvist the save, and Horvat is there to pick up the rebound. That is the Canucks' second goal of the game, and it's really nice looking. It's just a pure, like, Sedin goal. And this one was another good one, because Henrik Sedin is now at 40 points. I'm sorry, 40 assists. He's at, like, 43 points, by the way, mind you, because he's scored so little goals this year, it's kind of weird. But 40 assists for Henrik Sedin, he's still really good at playmaking. And if you continue on later into the second period, Daniel Sedin gets himself an unassisted goal. And with this goal and the assist earlier in the game, Daniel Sedin has now brought himself back up to 44 points in this season, which is the same amount of points he had last season, just in 19 less games. And this is his first 20-goal season ever since 2015-16, where he got himself 28. So if you want to talk about the Sedins, they still got it, and it's showing in this game. Daniel Sedin is up there. He's a 20-goal scorer once again. Namestnikov comes in on a breakaway. He gives the Rangers the lead once again. But then in the third period, we got ourselves two more Vancouver Canucks goals. I watched these ones, folks. I watched these ones. The first one, it is the end of the power play. You got Goldobin out there. He's out there instead of Brock Boeser, I believe. Horvat starts everything. He comes into the zone, passes it off to Brendan Leipsic. Leipsic, with some moves, gets through the defense, passes it off, and then there are a few more passes. Pouliot gets it at the point, over to Leipsic on the right side, cross ice to Goldobin on the left side. Power play expires, Goldobin shot, and another Henrik Lundqvist flying windmill attempt doesn't work. And Goldobin gets one here. Brendan Leipsic, with his first point as a Vancouver Canuck, absolutely deserved it. He was fire the whole game. But you know who else was fire in this game? Let's talk a little bit about Tyler Motte. He was playing on the fourth line here today, alongside of Sutter and I believe Archibald. Motte is an elite penalty killer. Holy Jesus. Holy. His ability to individually keep the Rangers hemmed in their own zone on the penalty kill. Oh my god. Tyler Motte is so good. I'm freaking out right now. Just watching Tyler Motte on the penalty kill is like watching Brock Boeser skating down the wing with the puck with open room. You're just excited, and you know that something is going to happen. Of course, you didn't really expect Tyler Motte to get a shorthanded goal while by himself in the Rangers zone, while the Rangers had like five guys in their zone, but Tyler Motte is so good at giving his teammates time and space to change on the penalty kill. Fantastic effort. Absolutely a great player in this one. Same with Brendan Leipsic, the two Canucks recruits. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic in this game. The new BBB line shined, and Tyler Motte was a penalty kill elite in this game. Brendan Leipsic with 7 shots and 2 assists in this game. Fantastic. What a fantastic way to start out your career in Vancouver. And I'm going to say that. I'm going to say he's probably going to stay with us for a bit. Because if he has that chemistry with Horvat and Boeser, like he has shown today, we don't need Berchi on the BBB line anymore. We got Brendan Leipsic. I'm sorry, Berchi. You're good. You're expendable. You can get played wherever and you can still succeed. Brendan Leipsic. He played better with Horvat and Boeser than I think Berchi has all season. So, yeah. We're still missing one more Vancouver goal, though, and this one is Brock Besser's second of the night. This one, ooh, my god, I freaked out on this one, and it was an absolutely beautiful goal here. This one is a 6-on-5 opportunity. Nielsen is at the bench. Gagne, absolutely getting robbed a few times by Lundqvist in the earlier moments. Wow, just Lundqvist was amazing in this game. We'll talk about him a little bit. Horvat, behind the net, sends it out over across the boards. Leipsic is there. They're kind of passing it back a little bit between themselves. Then Leipsic, all of a sudden, on the backhand, behind the goal line, he just throws it. He chucks it on the backhand, right through, over to Brock Boeser. And Boeser, as a right-handed shot, he receives the puck on his backhand. Jesper Fast, I believe, comes right rushing towards him. Besser's like, nope, and he pulls it back down. Then he cradles it a little bit. Then he holds it a little bit more, and then he shoots it, and it goes in, and I'm like, oh my god! Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Brock Boeser. The whole, like, 2 seconds where Boeser was cradling and moving with the puck to get around Fast and give himself a good shooting lane, I just, like, yo, the eyeballs in my head just popped out for a second, and, like, ugh, magic, magic. Brock Boeser scores a second of the game, and he's up. He is up. And the game is tied, and everyone's like, oh my god, we should have lost this game. Why did we score again? But then everyone's like, yeah, but it's Brock Boeser, so it's okay. And then all the other people were like, yeah, I guess it's okay. It's Brock Boeser. If it was anybody else, like, kind of would have been pissed off. But, yeah. And then the overtime happens, and then Brock Besser's out there. I think, oh my god, he's gonna get a hat trick, and then he misses the net or whatever. Something like that. He does a spin move, and he loses the puck. And then the Rangers come back, and then they score, and then the game is over. So we get the pity point. That's not good, but we don't get 2 points, so that is good. Brock Boeser gets himself 2 goals. That's really good. Leipsic gets himself 2 assists. Really, really good. Sedin's, Daniel with 2 points. Henrik with an assist. I just realized I didn't talk about Daniel's goal, huh? Henrik Sedin, at the hash marks, tries to pass it along, gets deflected by the New York guy in front. And he basically just touch passes it over to Daniel Sedin, who one time slap shots it, and it's in. So yeah, I totally forgot to talk about that one. But Sedin's, Daniel's back up there. He's equaled his point total from last year, so that's really good. And Henrik Lundqvist, an absolute showing of why he's been one of the most elite goaltenders in the past decade. 51 saves here, 55 shots, 4 goals let in. Just magnificent performance. The Canucks, fantastic here. Brendan Leipsic, I don't usually talk about things like this, but this is kind of important to me. Brendan Leipsic had a 70% Corsi or whatever. He was really good in this game. And Bo Horvat and Brock Boeser, especially in the first period that I was able to watch, they just carried. They just absolutely carried. And they were just skating around with it, passing it back to each other. Leipsic would get involved in the play and he'd support. He'd do his job well. He'd send it back over. And that line of BBB once again has just been tearing things up. And it's beautiful. And we get the team tank win here today. Realistically, though, we get the team tank overtime loss. Because we lost in overtime. We got 1 point, which we don't really necessarily need. But Boeser got 2 goals. Leipsic got 2 assists. Sedin, Daniel Sedin got 2 points. What a beautiful game. Horvat got a goal. Goldobin got a goal. All is good in Canuckland right now. And it's not even just the Vancouver Canucks. The Kelowna Rockets had a really weird game, too. I'll talk about that a little bit later. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sure, plus, and you're not sure, like, not sure, saying gaming, and bye.